Hello everyone, in this video, I will use a more efficient method to calibrate the Galvo head. The name of this method is 9-point calibration. First, we click the software and click open file location. Then we can find the Corefile tool application in the folder. We turn on the machine, then we double click this application. First step, we click F1, set laser parameters. First, we need to choose a laser type. For fiber laser machine, we should choose the third option, IPG. We keep the other parameters unchanged. We need to prepare a laser test paper and the caliper. If you don't have the laser test paper, you can use the black printing paper instead. We should make sure the laser test paper is flat and the laser is focused on the paper. The second step, we click F3, mark 9-point rectangle. Then we can get this pattern. We can compare the marking with the image in the software. We can see they are not totally the same. The positions and directions of the three small figures are not the same as those in the marking. We can click this button to change the image. We continue to adjust it until it is same as the marking. It should be noted that the directions and positions of the three small figures need to be exactly the same as the marking. We can see there are 9 points on the image. On the right hand side are the coordinates of each point. The coordinate of 5 is 0, 0. So 5 is the origin, 4, 5, 6 is the horizontal axis, 2, 5, 8 is the vertical axis. What we need to do is to measure the coordinate value of each point on the marking and input them into the corresponding box in the software. First, we measure the coordinate of point 1. It's 48.24. For these decimals, we only need to keep one digit after the decimal point. So it's 48.2. We only need to input positive numbers. Why is 51.1? Then we measure the coordinate of number 2. The x coordinate of this point is 0, so we just need to measure the y coordinate. It's 50.51. Then we measure the coordinate of number 3. It's 48.47. The y coordinate is 50.96. Then we measure the coordinate of number 4. The y coordinate of number 4 is 0, so we only need to measure the x coordinate. It's 50.22. Then we measure the coordinate of number 6. The y coordinate is 0, so we only need to measure the x coordinate. is 50.41. Then we measure the number 7. The x coordinate is 48.5. Then we measure the y coordinate. It's 50.88. Then we measure the number 8. The x coordinate is 0, so we only need to measure the y coordinate. It's about 50, so we don't need to change it. Finally, we measure the number 9. X is 49.09. We measure the Y coordinate. It's 50.81. The length I use is a 110 mm length. In fact, no matter what length you use, the method is same. You only need measure the coordinates of the 9 points and input them into the corresponding boxes in the software. Next step, click F6, save correct file. The file will be defaultly saved under documents. You can change the page. We name the file as file110. Save. Next step, we click F7, open correct file. To open the file we just saved. Then we need to prepare a new laser test paper and place it at the center. The marking area of this time is larger, so if your paper is not so big, you need to change a bigger paper. Next step, we click F8, calibrate the standard rectangle. Okay, we got a net-like pattern composed of many rectangles. First, we need to check whether the sides of these rectangles are distorted or not. Actually, we can see that the left of this rectangle is a bit distorted. And we need to check whether the distance between these lines is 5 mm, and we need to check both horizontally and vertically. In general, errors within 0.1 mm are acceptable. It depends on your requirement on the accuracy. If you think the shape is too distorted or the error is too big, you can go back to F3, re-measure and adjust those parameters. Okay, we open the software. Click F3. In the Field tab, we check this box. Use the correction file. Then we choose the file we created. Okay. Then we draw 100 by 100 mm square. And make a marking test. Okay, let's check the shape and the size of this square. There is actually an error. The error of one side is about 2 millimeters. If you are not satisfied with the accuracy, you can adjust it in F3 of Corefile 2. At my first adjustment, the pattern was obviously distorted when I click F8. Finally, I found that the orientation of this image has not been adjusted correctly. The positions of the diamond and the square were right, but the position and the direction of the line were wrong. So I'd also like to remind everyone to pay attention that the positions of these three figures should all be correct. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Leave a comment if you have any question. Thank you and see you next time.